Women to Women on BCTV is supported by the Women to Women program of the Greater Reading Chamber Alliance.
Welcome to the Greater Reading Chamber Alliance Women to Women Network Program. We're so happy to be here again today, and we're here to talk a little bit about Women to Women and what we all do to encourage women to create connections, gain knowledge, open doors, build strategic alliances, and much, much more. Our goal is to create more women leaders in Berks County by providing a forum where women from diverse backgrounds can share ideas and mentor each other. So I would like to introduce the Senior Director of Events and Special Programs at the Greater Reading Chamber, that's a mouthful, Alliance, and the Director of Women to Women, Rachael Romig. Welcome back, Rach.
Hello, how are you?
I'm great. It's so good to see you again, looking all festive in your red.
You got some red, too.
Yep, getting ready for the holiday season.
Yeah, I really am.
Yes.
Don't have any shopping done at all.
Oh, boy.
Yeah.
Well, there's plenty of time yet for that, right?
Gotta get on it.
Right. But, you know, it's so funny. I can't believe that 2023 or 2022 flew by already, and we're knocking right on the door of 2023.
Yeah.
So I know the Women to Women, we had a lot of great programs and a lot of great things that happened in 2022. And this time of year, it's always like people like to reflect back on the past year. And what can you tell us about Women to Women that you're really proud of?
Well, first off, I continue to say this year or this, we're in the year, and I keep already going to 2023 because my brain is so far into 2023 already, because we've just been planning all the events that I'll talk about a little bit later for Women to Women and beyond. But in 2022, we really did some great things. You know, for 2 years, COVID stopped us from doing anything, and we came back in full force. In 2020, we had our strategic planning session, and we planned out for 3 years. And of course, two of those just got destroyed. So what we were able to do in that time was to really prep for 2023, because that was the final year for our strategic plan. So really in the background, doing the work to hit the goals that we'd like to set. And in this year, we really took all that back work and pushed it forward really quickly. We just announced our impact report for the year, and we grew in our reach across the community and beyond like tenfold. We have almost 3,000 Facebook likes and followers, about 1,500 Instagram followers. Our LinkedIn network has really exploded. That really encompasses women and men from much further than Berks County, because I am pretty active on LinkedIn and like different people doing different things within the nation and the world. And I think those people are also reciprocating and they want to know what we're doing. So I think that's really, really exciting that it has grown so much across LinkedIn. And over 5,000 women that we reach through email. We have an e-newsletter that we've upped to twice a month, actually, because we have so much going on all the time. And we've really been putting a lot of community events in the newsletters and ways you can volunteer and just recaps of our initiatives and our events, because you know, people love seeing themselves in the photos that we share at our events, across social media, but seeing your face on a newsletter is always really fun. So we've just had so much information to share that we have been pushing it out hard. In 2022, we had 7 in-person Women to Women events, 6 Mujer a Mujer events, our annual conference and expo, our evening of empowerment, a few networking experiences, and we hosted 1 lean-in circle with a professional facilitator. Her name's Denise Lee from Herbine HR Mosteller Associates. We reached over almost 600 women across our events, 200 plus for Mujer a Mujer, which has been growing since that really disappeared during COVID. Our annual conference and expo, we sold out the Santana Performing Arts Center, and we had 40 vendors in our women-owned business, sponsor, and local nonprofit expo. We had over 180 attendees at the Evening of Empowerment, which we almost sold out, took up all the space in the Abraham Lincoln's Ballroom. Our networking experiences, we got to partner with different community entities, from the Miller Center to going to Foligno Estate. We had networking and wreath making and a fun women's only viewing of an event at the Miller Center. And we had 14 people in lean-in circles, which is always really fun. That's a really intense development opportunity for women.
Yeah, it's so great to try some of the different venues throughout Berks County and seeing different places. So it's really fun to do that.
Yeah, we certainly try to spread the love for our GRCA members. I oversee all of the events for GRCA, so I get to really see where we're putting our events. And I want to bring people into the city of Reading. I want to take them out past Kutztown. I mean, Berks County's so big, so while we lost some venues, there are a lot of great venues in the area, and I really want to go to all of them.
Yeah, it's really fun to explore them.
Mm-hmm.
So I've heard you've done a lot to try to attract younger women coming to women-to-women events, too. What can you tell me about that, Rach?
That was one of our big strategic goals for 2020, to reach these younger ladies, because they're our next leaders. So if we're not reaching them, we're not hearing their opinions and what matters most to them. So just in November, we hosted a mentorship event where we had a mentor-mentee relationship speak briefly, and then we had about almost 100 people network intentionally and go from table to table. 40% of the crowd were high school and college students. And that is a very, very, very big deal to me. You know, it's hard to engage young people if they've never been in this professional sphere. You know, you have to have a mentor or an advocate saying, come along, let's go. And I wanted to thank a couple people actually that really made that possible. Christy Tarafenko from Voice Up Berks has been integral in getting young women to the table that are involved with Voice Up. Christy Bonanno, she is from Governor Mifflin High School. She truly advocates for young ladies in the school district and has brought some women to many, many events. So it's always great to work with her. Michelle Conway with Alvernia University is bringing college students all the time. And there were so many more that reached out, women who brought their daughter, who brought a friend, you know, told their friends. And because of that, we had this awesome mix of women in this networking room. At the same time, we offer complimentary headshots for those young ladies to start a LinkedIn profile, to update a LinkedIn profile. So we really are trying to set them up for success and introduce them to professional working women, tenured women, to give them those life experiences. So it's just something I could talk about it forever and ever and ever. I thought it was amazing.
That's great. It's just like a small thing like that to help a younger woman gain some confidence, getting a professional picture to help on social media and selling themselves. That's just a small thing like that is so fantastic.
It really, really is. And they got to meet these older women and hear about some of their experiences and just what they do. Because there's also a really good portion of younger students who don't know what they want to do. Obviously, adults don't know what they want to do, but they also don't know what's available to them.
Right.
They have no idea what career they could have. So seeing someone that's doing something that you kind of like is just really neat. And I wanted to share two testimonials, actually. One from Christy Bonanno. We asked a lot of people why bringing young women to the table is so vital. And she said, I brought three students to the event who are amazing young women. One of the young ladies is very outgoing and the other two a little more introverted. She wanted them to be around strong women and have the opportunity to talk to them. And this event was perfect. And she shared after the fact that one of the introverted young ladies, she sat with her in the beginning to kind of help her get along. And then by the end of the event, this girl was just talking and felt comfortable in her skin and, you know, was asking great questions. So it was clear that she felt it was like it was a safe space to grow. And that's what we want to see.
Yeah, that's what it's all about.
It is.
Yeah.
And another woman who's new to the community, her name is Kitty Jackson. She said, I bring experience and a voice of minority women to that event and to the next generation. As someone who has consistently been a mentor since 2011. I recognize what girls and young women need, and I want to be a support system for many. And I have to say, as she shared, being a minority woman, our crowd was extremely diverse, and it was awesome.
That's
it was
great.
Awesome. So that being one of the things, what was one of our goals as well, to really make sure that we represent our community, that's working as well.
Well, speaking about representing our community, I know, during COVID, you had mentioned that Day Mujer kind of dropped off and, mm-hmm. We weren't able to meet in person, and a lot of the ladies that have been regularly participating in that weren't able to do so. But now, just within the last year, we started getting things going again. So has it been going well?
It has been going well, and the attendance has been growing month after month. As many know, we always meet on the second Thursday of the month at 5:30 p.m. Previously met at Caliente at the Crown Plaza. That's want. We can't do that anymore. So the first few events were really a welcome back party. There was no set schedule or speaker, and it was a place to network and revisit what we'd done in the past and really reintegrate people into Mujer a Mujer and what we do. I want to thank Johanny Zapata and Mi Casa Su Casa. When the Crown Plaza went down, it was just a couple days before our event, and she said, come to me. And we hosted the event at Mi Casa Su Casa at no charge, and we were able to still bring women together. And, I'd love to go back there again, but we have 100%, we've outgrown the space already. Within that one event, we outgrew it. So also want to thank the Abraham Lincoln and their event staff. We now are going there for our events, and it's been really great. We will continue to do so in 2023.
That's such a beautiful venue.
It is.
It really is.
And, we've been wanting to have events central to the city.
Right.
And there's parking, and, we always bring some food. So it's great networking and great sessions. But it's so, so exciting to see it come back to life with a lot of new women in the crowd. Every event, women, or Mujer a Mujer, I ask, who's new? And a good 25 to 30% are always new. So that is another real great sign. I'm just excited to talk about it because it seems like everything that we put into place while we couldn't do anything for COVID has exploded in such a positive way. And thank you to Lourdes Peralta from Sarai Variety Flowers. She always brings flowers to our Mujer a Mujer events so that we can raffle them off to bring some cheer to the ladies in the room.
And they're beautiful. Oh, she does such an amazing job. She really does.
She does. And if you've ever been to a Women2Women event, they're normally her flowers on the table that we say, please take them at the end. So she's wonderful. But as I mentioned, we're going to be meeting at the Abraham Lincoln in 2023 in their beautiful Roosevelt suite. It's a little larger for our growth. And we do meet the second Thursday of every month from 5:30 to 7. And there's always some light appetizers included.
That's great. I'm so glad that that's up and rolling again. But it sounds like you got a lot rolling and moving into 2023, a lot of momentum going, and a lot of great events planned. So what have you got cooking for 2023, Rachel?
Well, if I couldn't be any more excited. let's see. So 2023 did stop our current strategic plan. So we're going to start strategic planning again for the next few years. And that is exciting because just from our plan this year, it's almost like, what more? How can we grow more? Like, what can we do? I can't wait to have the strategic planning session. We always have it at East Penn, which has been wonderful. And we have it professionally facilitated. So there's, and you know this, Allison gets the blood pumping with Zumba as we stand there. But just a great space for brainstorming, and that is where the best ideas come from. So we really throw out all the ideas we can think of, and we put it on the board, and then we really start getting into the nitty-gritty of, okay, does this make sense for us? Do we see any themes, and how can we accomplish this with, quantifiable actions? So some of the things that we're going to continue and put into place we did start talking about an ambassador program in 2022, where we're reaching out to different sectors of the community to just make new connections, show that we want to be a partner to the community while we're saying, hey, this is what we do, and we'd love for you to join us. Let's talk about what you do and how we can support you as well. So the ambassador program has been researched, is ready to roll, and it's going to roll out hard in 2023. So I'm really excited to make those new community partnerships and keep them flowing. We also, in 2022, hosted a regional women's networking event. We as Women2Women in Berks, the Harrisburg Chamber Women's Group, the Lancaster County Chamber Women's Group, and the York Women's Group and Chamber, we all came together in Lancaster, and that was something that I started planning in 2019, and then it just stopped. So we got about 60 women together, and we're going to be doing this annually now. So we already have that scheduled for, I believe, October of next year. So we will continue to cross those boundary lines and get women to meet other women who are doing good things in their community. We're also going to be hosting a networking event with local women's groups. So we realize, oh, people are so excited to meet other women regionally. I wonder if the women who go to this networking group for women in Berks know about Women2Women and vice versa. And I wonder what that overlap is. So there is nothing competitive about women's advancement at all. So I can't wait to work with these local women's groups to have a networking event. And if there is not overlap, learn about one another, because there might be a woman who wants to go to this smaller networking group and needs that. So really can't wait for that. We're going to continue outreach to next gen leaders, the ladies. So we are keeping in tap with local colleges for career fairs, internship fairs, any kind of fair that we can have a table and just say, we exist and we're a resource for you. So just know that you can turn to us as you're starting your professional career. If you want to get started, we can maybe connect you with someone that you are similar to or not similar to, and you can learn something new. So we're going to keep doing that. And we have an intern coming on in January who's going to be doing a lot of marketing, storytelling things for us, really consolidated in January to prep for the new year. That marketing piece is so extremely important to get stories and testimonials and maybe some photos so that we can continue to share that with the community, make sure everyone's represented, and just make sure everyone understands what Women2Women is. So as you can tell, like, this theme of growth for 2023 is just expanding what we know is working, but at the same time, making sure everyone knows who we are and then supporting them back in return.
Wow. I don't know how you do it all, Rachel. You're really amazing, because along with just Women2Women, that's just one segment of your job. You also oversee all the events for the Greater Reading Chamber Alliance. So,
you know,
it's a lot.
It all fits together.
Yeah.
I get to use GRCA members for everything, and, you know, I just love that, you know, we can also promote Women2Women and its importance to the entirety of GRCA and vice versa. Even into 2023, we do have a training and development department, and we are offering a discount to anyone at Women2Women who wants to go through the training programs.
Wow.
So we're going to start marketing that and advertising that more, because it's like a development pathway. So you can come to Women2Women, learn these skills, now hop on over to something that's both male and female, and exercise those skills and get better at it, and you get a discount too. So
it's a win-win.
It is a win-win.
That's great. Well, thank you for all of your hard work that you do for Women2Women. We greatly appreciate it, and so does the community of Berks County. It's just great that there's an avenue for women to be able to build their skills, to get more confidence, and build more women leadership in Berks County and throughout the United States. We really need that. And so we are so excited again to have Rachel here on the show today. And remember, if you're interested in becoming a member of Women2Women, there's a couple things you can do. You can go onto the website of the Greater Reading Chamber, and it's Berks2Women.com, and sign up to be on the email list. That way you can get advance notice of all the events that are happening. You can make sure that you get an invite and you know what's going on and what the next great event is for Berks Women2Women. So we thank you so much. We hope to see you at one of our events, and we can't wait till the next time we get together. Yeah. Thanks, Rachel.
Thank you, Allison.
Women2Women on BCTV is supported by the Women2Women program of the Greater Reading Chamber Alliance.